In this video, we'll go over the 10 best cards in the game, which have effects that increase your life points. And at number 10, we have Emergency Provisions, basically on here for historical reasons. This is a quick play spell card that allows you to send any number of your spell and trap cards you control to the graveyard in order to gain 1,000 life points for each card sent to the graveyard in this way. And one of the easy ways you could use this card in order to gain life points was to just send cards you had already activated that were going to the graveyard immediately anyway, as most cards don't need to stay on the field for their effects to resolve. So you could activate this at the end of a long chain to just gain life points off of all the cards that you're about to activate anyway. And you could also use it to send cards to the graveyard with negative effects that you don't want to go off. And this card was considered good enough that it was actually placed on the ban list and limited to one copy. But then they took it off very soon after, because here's the thing about life point gain cards. Unless they do something else, they're not useful. A card which causes you to gain life points needs to do something else as well. Otherwise, it's not worth using, because just gaining life points for yourself doesn't really advance the game state, because it doesn't matter what your life points are, as long as your opponent's life points become zero. That's why cards like Solemn Judgment, a card that lets you pay half your life points to negate any one card, is considered so good, because the life point cost doesn't matter. As long as you have one life point, you can still win the duel. And the only use life point gain cards have are in decks that are specifically trying to gain life points in order to do something else, like Aromages, who need you to gain life points in order to activate their effects. Or if you're using cards like Backup Squad, a card which can convert your high life point value into card advantage for yourself, as that will allow you to last long enough for your opponent to attack into enough times to draw enough cards. Or if you're using cards that increase your opponent's life points in order to convert it into burn damage, like with Bad Reaction to Samachi. Now, the only use life point gain cards have in the game are ones that coincidentally also do something else useful as well. In this video though, I'll try my best to stick to just pure life point gain cards instead of really good cards that just happen to have a life point gain component to them. And at number 9, we have Gingerbread House. This one kind of immediately breaks the rule I just set for myself, where I want to list pure life point gain cards instead of just cards with good effects that just happen to also gain life points, because this card kind of falls into that category. Because what it does is, every turn during your opponent's standby phase, you can increase the attack of all of your opponent's monsters by 600. And then, after you increase their attack, you can destroy all of your opponent's monsters who have 2500 or more attack. So, if your opponent has two cards with 1900 attack on the field, and then this card gives them 600 attack each, bringing them both up to 2500 attack points, this card would then immediately destroy them for being at the attack power value. And then, if you destroy monsters with this effect, you get to gain life points equal to the number of monsters destroyed times 500. So, in my theoretical example, you would gain 1,000 life points for destroying two cards. Now, what's great about this card is that it just happens every turn without you having to really do anything else. So, if you're playing a stall deck, this card would eventually allow you to just destroy all of your opponent's monsters, as those monsters would eventually go above the 2500 attack power threshold due to this card's effect giving them 600 attack every turn. And then, when it destroys cards, it also allows you to gain life points, which does actually synergize well with the incredibly few life point gain decks that are out there, which are basically stall decks trying to get high life point values for Backup Squad to give them more card draw. Although the life point gain feature of this card is nice, that's not really the main function of this card. It doesn't give you a whole lot of life points, which is why I put it at a low spot at number 9. Because it's still a lot better than most of the monster cards that give you life points, because a lot of those require you to use up your normal summon in order to use them, which automatically makes them worse than a spell or trap card like this. Especially one that also just passively destroys all of your opponent's monsters. And at number 8, we have Cauldron of the Old Man. This card has an effect where, once per turn, you can gain 500 life points times the number of counters that are on this card. And this card gains one counter as soon as it's activated, and then it gains an additional one during each of your standby phases. And what's great about this card is that the gaining the life points from its effect does not remove the counters. So, on your first turn, you can gain 500 life points with its effect, and then on your next turn, you can gain 1,000, and in the turn after that, you can gain 1,500. and so on and so on. As the longer this card stays on the field, the more life points you gain each turn when you use its effect. And you can also choose to use its effect to inflict burn damage to your opponent at a 300 point value per counter instead of 500. So if you had 3 counters on this card, it would inflict 900 points of damage to your opponent, instead of using its effect to give yourself 1500 life points, which is not half bad. If you're running a life point gain deck, a card like this is infinitely better than something like Solemn Wishes, which only gives you 500 life points every time you draw a card, which is really limited in how many times it can give you 500 life points per turn. And then if you stall long enough, and this card has enough counters on it, you could just start inflicting damage to your opponent instead, and have a real win condition right there. This card is very vulnerable to spell and trap card destruction though, and doesn't really advance the board like Gingerbread House does, so it's not really the best card in the world, but it is a good life point gain card, which is why it makes it on this list. And at number 7, we have the Golden Ladybug. During your standby phase, you can just reveal this card in your hand in order to gain 500 life points, but then this card stays revealed in your hand until the end of the turn. Now, what makes this card better than cards like Cauldron of the Old Man or Solemn Wishes is that this card stays in your hand, so it's not vulnerable to your opponent's spell and trap card destruction or any other board removal cards. The only way your opponent can stop this card is by discarding it from your hand, which is an incredibly difficult and rare effect to have, that if your opponent could discard this card from your hand, they would probably choose a different target anyway. They could also use effect negation on it though, but you know, who's going to use that on a Golden Ladybug? So, only gaining 500 life points per turn is not the best life point gain in the world, and Cauldron of the Old Man and Solemn Wishes have the potential to give you more life points per turn. The protection that Golden Ladybug has, i.e. being a card in your hand instead of one on the field, just makes it better if you're trying to passively gain life points every turn. The downside to this card is that it takes up a card in your hand in order to gain this incredibly mediocre effect, but this is a list about life point gain cards, so we're not really thinking about useful cards too much, at least not until we get to the higher spots on this list. And at number 6, we have Try and Guess. Now, this card has the potential to allow you to gain 3,000 life points, or force your opponent to gain 3,000 life points, both of which are good effects. Because what it does is that when you activate this card, you must declare one extra deck monster type, either Fusion, Synchro, or Xyz. Since this card was introduced before Link Monsters, it doesn't actually allow you to declare that type of extra deck monster. And then, whichever player has more cards of that type in their extra deck, will gain 3,000 life points. So if you want to gain 3,000 life points with this card, all you have to do is fill your extra deck with nothing but Fusion monsters. And since you'll have 15 Fusion monsters, 99% of the time you'll have more Fusion monsters in your extra deck than your opponent, because the average deck plays a lot of Link monsters in order to allow themselves to have more extra deck spaces. Although honestly, since most decks run at least one Link monster, you could just fill your extra deck with Synchro or Xyz cards as well. And then as long as you just have 15 of either of those three, you should be able to win the guess and gain 3,000 life points. However, if you want your opponent to gain 3,000 life points, because you're playing a bad reaction to Samachi deck, where it converts life point gains into burn damage, and 3,000 points of burn damage from one card is really good, then what you'd want to do is have only Link monsters in your extra deck, and then call either of the three extra deck types that you think your opponent might have. In which case, you might want to call Fusion monsters, because most players use Instant Fusion or Super Polymerization. Whatever you think your opponent will have in their extra deck, because as long as they have one of them, this card will treat your Link monster as if you had zero cards, and your opponent will automatically win, and automatically grant your opponent a win for having more of the declared type, and give them 3,000 life points, which you can then convert into burn damage if you're playing a Nurse Burn deck. This is one of the few Nurse Burn specific cards that is also just a good life point gain card for yourself. If you want a one card, gain a whole bunch of life points without any other kinds of gameplay restrictions type thing, as none of the other cards in the game give you as big of a life point boost without some other kind of setup or cost, besides setting up your extra deck before the game starts. As Try and Guess at a 3,000 life point boost makes it one of the highest ones in the game. Although since all this card does is give you life points, it's still not the best life point gain card, as the other ones at higher spots are just a little bit better. And also, some fun facts about this card. It's the only card in the game that forces your opponent to reveal their entire extra deck. And this card is also sometimes banned from World Championship tournaments, because of how easily this card can gain you a big chunk of life points. And funny enough, so is Mystic Walk, a quick play spell card that lets you tribute a monster in order to gain life points equal to its attack or defense. Both of these cards are usually banned from the World Championship tournament, specifically because of how easy they can give you a huge chunk of life points in one turn, in order to take advantage of the new time rules, where whoever has the most life points at the end of the duel, if time has run out, wins the last duel of that match. And at number 5, we have Soul Absorption. Now, while Try and Guess might be the highest life points you can gain from a single card, without any kind of board or gameplay setup, as all you have to do is set up your extra deck before the duel starts, then Soul Absorption would be the highest life point gain card that does require you to build your deck around it, and doesn't require some kind of infinite loop, as this card gives you 5,000 life points if a card is banished, no matter how a card is banished, or whoever's card is banished. So, if you banish a card like Necroface, you'll gain 500 life points for that card being banished, and then Necroface herself has an effect that when it's banished, you can banish the top 5 cards of both players' decks, which would result in 10 cards total being banished, and then this card would give you 5,000 life points, because it doesn't care whose cards are getting banished, or from where. So, if you use a card like Eater of Millions to banish all 15 cards in your extra deck in order to bring it out, you'd gain 7,500 life points. If you banish 10 cards face down for the effect upon a desires, you gain 5,000 life points, and so on and so on. This card allows you to gain a ton of life points for some really good banished cards, and the only problem with this card is that the decks that can allow you to gain a whole bunch of life points with this don't really care about having high life point values. Because sure, gaining 5,000 life points from a good card that people run anyway sounds like a good idea, but it's not enough life points to really be worth playing Soul Absorption. Because if your opponent breaks your board and destroys this card, that extra life point bubble might only buy you one turn of not getting instantly OTK'd. In which case, you'd still be behind in the game state, and buying yourself an extra turn won't help you much more than playing a single copy of Threatening Roar would. High life point gains are only useful in decks specifically designed to take advantage of high life point values, using stuff like Ancient Leaf or Backup Squad. And since Soul Absorption is a hard to search out continuous spell card, you can't really rely on having Soul Absorption in those kinds of decks either. So while it may be a really good life point gain card, it's just not really useful in the kinds of decks that could allow you to gain the most amount of life points from it. And pure life point gain decks can't make use of this card either, as they don't really banish very much, but it still allows you to gain a ton of life points, which allows it to take a high spot on this list nonetheless. And at number 4, we have Checksum Dragon. This is a level 6 hand trap, where if your opponent declares an attack, you can special summon this card from your hand, and then gain life points equal to half of this card's defense, which is 2400. And also, if this card is in attack mode, it cannot be destroyed by battle. So, by default, this card allows you to gain 1200 life points. Now, that 1200 life point value isn't the most useful thing in the world. However, here's what's so good about this card. It allows you to do something else beneficial in addition to gaining that life points, which is not half bad at an amount of 1200, especially if you're in a deck that wants to gain incremental life point increases, while also having cards that are good at other things in addition to gaining life points. Because with this card's 2400 defense power value, you can just activate this card once your opponent has low attack monsters left on their side of the field in order to block them out for the rest of the battle phase, gaining life points, and then you'll have a dark dragon type monster on your side of the field for the next turn, which is actually a good type and attribute to have. Alternatively, if you just want to lower the amount of damage you're taking for the turn, or if you want this card to survive to your next turn no matter what, you can place this card into attack position, and it will be guaranteed to survive the battle phase. You'll just get a little bit of extra life points to hopefully not lose to all the damage that's about to come in, as this card has really low attack, and be almost guaranteed to have the card in your next turn for a few extra deck plays. This is all actually pretty good stuff, especially since a similar card, called Salaman Great Paro, which is basically an archetype-specific version of Checksum Dragon, where if your opponent declares an attack, you can special summon this card from your hand, and then it can change its attack power value to that of a Salaman Great Monster in your graveyard. So if you had a really strong one in your grave, you could give this one a really high attack power value to basically block out the battle phase. Alternatively, you could then tribute this card in order to gain 2,000 life points, which is why people were using this card because of the new time rules. Checksum Dragon is better as a generic card because it doesn't rely on specific archetype in order to be useful, as it will gain the life points immediately with the baseline defense of 2,400. It's much more likely to block out the rest of the battle phase if used at the right time, whereas Salamangreat Paro only has 2,000 base attack and only gains life points if you specifically tribute the card during your next turn. Although, since Salamangreat Paro is part of a meta archetype, it sees more play than Checksum Dragon and is at least worth the mention. And at number 3, we have Jura-Ghetto. Now this card is like a poster child for what a card that can gain life points should do in order for it to see any kind of play. Because what this card does is you can special summon it from your hand during the battle phase, just straight up. If it's the battle phase during either player's turn and this card is in your hand, you can special summon it whenever you want. And you don't have to wait for an attack like you do with Checksum Dragon. And then when this card is special summoned by its effect, you gain 1,000 life points. It's also a level 4 monster with decent stats for a monster that can special summon itself at 1,700. Because usually monsters that can special summon themselves have really low attack power values. And it has a quick effect where it can tribute itself to increase the attack of another monster you control by 1,000 until the end of the next turn. So if you want to play a monster that gives you life points, you want it to be able to special summon itself in order for it to be of any kind of use. Unlike cards like Spicy Spy, who has the potential to give you more life points, but takes up your normal summon, or Neospacian Air Hummingbird, who has the potential to give you even more life points, but also has low stats and takes up your normal summon. Jura-Ghetto might not give you as much life points as those two cards, but it has better stats, can special summon itself, which is the big thing, and the life points it does give you is not half bad. A 1,000 life point boost is a pretty decent amount for all the versatility this card has, because that 1,000 attack boost it can give lasts for 2 turns, as it's until the end of the next turn. So if your opponent is trying to destroy this card with a card effect, you can tribute it in response to that destruction to boost up one of your other monster's attacks for 2 turns. Or you can bring this card out during your battle phase, attack with it, and then give one of your other monsters a boost so it can attack over something else. And this card actually saw competitive play during the early days of Cosmo decks, as it was used to boost up Cosmo Farm Girl, so that it could use its effect to add Cosmo cards to your hand, which you could then tag out for. In the current metagame, monsters that can special summon themselves are very valuable, but really only for being able to do it during your main phase 1, and since this card can only special summon itself during the battle phase, it's almost exclusively limited to decks that actually want it for its life point boost, or want it for the attack boost, or just want the versatility this card allows for having both of those things plus decent stats on the board. But either way, it's a really good card with a decent life point gain effect attached to it. And at number 2, we have Ghost Sister and Spooky Dogwood. Now, in order for a life point gain card to see play in decks outside of decks that are specifically trying to gain life points, they need to allow you to gain a ridiculous amount of life points during the turn under normal playing conditions. So, unlike something like Soul Absorption. And Ghost Sister and Spooky Dogwood is probably the closest card to accomplishing that goal than any other card in the game, as you can discard this card from your hand in order to gain the effect for a turn, where each time your opponent special summons an effect monster, you gain life points equal to those monster's attack. So if you use this card at the start of your opponent's main phase 1, in response to a chain of something that's probably going to special summon a card, this can sometimes stop your opponent from doing any kind of combos they were going to do for the rest of the turn. Because the amount of life points you gain from them going through a normal combo would be so much that it honestly gets people to think twice about continuing their plays for the turn. And if this card can gain you so many life points, where it can essentially shut down a player from doing anything for a turn, that's pretty good. But there is also a downside to this card that strongly encourages people to not do anything for the turn as well, where if you do not gain life points by this effect, your life points are instead cut in half during the end phase. So sometimes a player will choose not to do anything during their turn if you activate this card at the start of their main phase, just so your life points will be cut in half. This card is still one of the best life point gain cards in the game though, and it's probably the only life point gain card that sees play in normal decks, which is why it definitely deserves its high spot on this list, just not the number one spot, because nothing can really top the number one. And at number one, we have Rainbow Life, a card which is routinely banned every year from the World Championship Tournament. Basically, this card has the effect where you can discard one card, and then until the end phase, whenever you would take any kind of damage, you instead gain that amount of life points. So, if your opponent attacks you with a 2000 attack monster directly, and you use this card, you'll gain 2000 life points from the attack. And since your opponent can't inflict battle damage to you for the rest of the turn, it completely stops out a battle phase. Now, what makes this card better than something like a Draining Shield, which can also negate a monster attack and then gain life points equal to that monster's attack, without having you to discard one card from your hand, which is actually a pretty big cost, is that Rainbow Life can be activated at any point during yours or your opponent's turn, whereas Draining Shield can only be activated in response to a monster attacking you. So if your opponent tries to clear your back row before they enter the battle phase, they can just destroy your Draining Shield and never have it trigger. Whereas you could chain Rainbow Life to being destroyed in order to still gain its effect for the turn. Although its ability to stop attacks for one turn is not why this card is banned from World Tournaments. The reason this card is banned is because it can allow you to gain an infinite amount of life points, which really messes up tournaments that are trying to stick to a time schedule. And if you spend your entire turn just gaining an infinite amount of life points through a repeatable combo, then you could theoretically just stay on your turn forever, and your opponent would not be able to inflict enough damage to you in order to win. If you're able to bring out a synchro monster called Colossal Fighter, and your opponent has a monster that has a higher attack power value than it, your Colossal Fighter can just crash into that monster, destroy itself by battle, and then special summon itself from the graveyard immediately with its own effect, in order to infinitely crash into your opponent's monster, and then if you have Rainbow Life active, you'll just gain life points equal to that minor attack power difference. And you can just do this as many times as you want, and you'll have an infinite amount of life points. It's kind of like a legal infinite loop that does result in a change of game state, which is why they banned this card during World Tournaments, because I think someone did try this during one of the tournaments one year. I could be wrong about it though, but I'm pretty sure that's why they ban it every year, even though it's not really a viable strategy. And of all the cards in this list, only Rainbow Life is capable of allowing you to gain an infinite amount of life points, I think, which really does make it one of the best life point gain cards in the game. Alright, and that's the end of the video. If you know of any other life point gain cards that I missed, or have ideas for future videos just like this one, I'd love to hear about them down in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe for weekly videos just like this one.